salary income. So firstly, we should know the meaning of salary. A salary is a form of periodic payment from an employer to an employee, which may be specified in an employment contract. It is contrasted with piece wages, where each job, hour, or other unit is paid separately rather than on a periodic basis. From the point of a business, salary can also be viewed as the cost of acquiring human resources for running operations and is then termed personal expense or salary expense. In accounting, salaries are recorded in payroll accounts. As per income tax, salary is the remuneration received by or accruing periodically to an individual for service rendered as a result of expressed or implied contract. Compensation or remuneration, even in the following circumstances, is chargeable to income tax under the heads salaries. When due from the former employer or present employer in the previous year, whether paid or not. When paid or allowed in the previous year by or on behalf of a former employer or present employer, though not due or before it becomes due. When arrears of salary are paid in the previous year by or on behalf of a former employer or present employer, if not charged to tax in the period to which it relates. It is, therefore, clear that apart from current year's salary, even advance salary and or arrears of salary may be taxed in the year of receipt. More specifically and elaborately, the Income Tax Act has stipulated that salary includes salary including advance or arrears of salary, wages, fees, commission, pension, annuity, perquisite. There are a few factors which require consideration. The most important of them are, while calculating business income of the employer, remuneration paid to employees is fully deductible while calculating taxable income, otherwise the tax bill goes up. One has to ensure that remuneration received by the employees and in the form it is received should enable minimum tax in the employees' hands and maximize take-home pay. After studying this lesson, you should be able to different forms of allowances and prerequisites, tax incidence in the hands of employees. Now let's discuss tax incidence in the hand of employees. Tax incident is said to fall upon the group that at the end of the day bears the burden of the tax. The key concept is that the tax incidence or tax burden does not depend on where the revenue is collected, but on the price elasticity of demand and price elasticity of supply. For example, a tax on apple farmers might actually be paid by the owners of agricultural land or consumers of apples. It can be covered under two heads, taxation of perquisites and ESOP. First is taxation to perquisites. Prior to amendment by the Finance No. 2 Act 2009, FA 2009, the taxation of perquisites provided to employees was divided between FPT, that is taxable in the employer's hands, and the erstwhile rule, that is taxable in the employee's hands, as follows. Where the employers were liable for FPT, perquisites like employee stock option plans, ESOPs, contribution to approved superannuation funds, motor cars, club expenses, gifts, scholarships, etc. were taxable in the hands of the employers as FPT. Where the employers were not liable to FPT, that is individuals, charities, political parties, etc., the perquisites listed in A above continued to be taxable in the hands of their employees under the erstwhile rule. Certain perquisites like employer-provided accommodation, provision of servant, sweeper, gardener, payment of utilities, etc. continued to be taxable in the hands of the employees in all cases. The FA 2009 enacted on 19th August 2009 withdrew FBT and restored the taxation of perquisites on the lines of the erstwhile rule with effect from 1 April 2009. The erstwhile rule, which had undergone amendments to align it with the FBT provisions, also required amendments to become fully applicable as before. The taxpayers eagerly awaited that revised rules, the revised rules. After a long wait, the new rule prescribing the revised perquisite valuation norms has been notified on 18th December 2009 with retrospective effect from 1st April 2009. Next is the ESOP. Prior to amendment by the FA 2009, if any shares or securities were provided free of cost or at a discount to the employees, the benefit was taxable in the hands of the employers as FBT at the stage of exercise of options or allotment of shares. The taxable value of the benefit was equal to the fair market value, FMV, of the said shares or securities as on the date of vesting of options, as reduced by any amount paid by or recovered from the employee. Post-amendment by the FA 2009 with effect from 1st April 2009, the aforesaid benefit is now taxable in the hands of the employees at the stage of exercise of options or allotment of shares. The stage of taxation continues to be at the stage of exercise of options or allotment of shares. However, the taxable value of the benefit is equal to the FMV of the said shares or securities as on the date of exercise of options or allotment of shares or securities as reduced by any amount paid by or recovered from the employee. In other words, while the timing of taxation and the method of calculation of FMV remains the same, the calculation date of FMV has shifted from vesting to exert. Now let's discuss fringe benefits and amenities. Fringe benefits are compensations made to an employee beyond the regular benefit of being paid for their work. Some fringe benefits are fairly standard, such as offering a few days of sick time or paid vacation time. Others can be significantly greater and rarer. Key executives in large companies might also enjoy fringe benefits like use of timeshare condominiums, paid continuing education, use of a company jet, use of a company credit card, discounted or free health club memberships, and a significant amount of paid vacation. Fringe benefits tax, FBT, is the tax applied to most, although not all, fringe benefits. The following items are covered: employer's expenses on entertainment, travel, employee welfare, and accommodation. The definition of fringe benefits that have become taxable has been significantly extended. The law provides an exact list of taxable items. Employer's provision of employee transportation to work or a cash allowance for this purpose. Employer's contributions to an approved retirement plan called a superannuation fund. Employee stock option plans, ESOPs, have also been brought under fringe benefit tax from the fiscal year 2007-08. Fringe benefits are deemed fringe benefits provided to the employees which are chargeable to fringe benefit tax in the hands of the employer are conveyance, use of hotel, boarding and lodging facilities, repair, running maintenance of motor cars including depreciation thereon, repair, running maintenance of aircrafts including depreciation thereon, use of telephones including mobile phones other than expenditure on leased telephone lines, festival celebrations, any free or concessional ticket provided by the employer for private journeys of his employees or their family members, any contribution by the employer to an improved superannuation fund for employees. Now, before we go further, firstly, we should understand perquisites taxable in the hands of specified employees, Section 17(2), Part 3. These are motor car facility, Rule 3(2), gas, electricity or water supply provided, Rule 3, Part 4, domestic servant, sweeper, gardener, watchman or personal attendant, cook, etc., Rule 3, Part 3. Education facility, medical facilities provided, proviso to Section 17, Part 2. Free or concessional journey given to the transport employees and their family members. Residual clause, treatment of any other benefit, amenity, etc. provided by the employer. The first is motor car facility. If the car owned by the employee and expenses made by him, then it's not a perquisite, either used for private or official purpose. If car owned by the employee and the expenses are reimbursed by the employer, then it will be perquisite of value actual expenses of employer less amount recovered from the employee balance amount will be perquisites in employee's hand. If car is owned or hired by the employer and expenses made by the employer, then it will be a perquisite of value of actual expenses by employer plus depreciation, 10% of the original cost of the car, or hire charges if the car is hired, less amount recovered from the employee if used privately. If the car is owned or hired by the employer and expenses made by the employee, the perquisite is a value depreciation, 10% of the original cost of the car or hire charges plus chauffeur salary, less amount recovered from the employee. Second is gas, electricity or water supply provided. Rule 3, Part 4. It can be from two sources. One is provided by outsiders and second one is supplied from own resources. In both the cases, the amount charged from employees is deducted from the two sources' expenses. Third is domestic servant. There are also in two ways. One is who are engaged by employer themselves and another is when they are engaged by employees but paid by employer. If gardener is provided along with rent-free accommodation owned by ER, then salary of garden plus all expenses for maintenance of garden are not taxable separately. Next is education facility, where the education institution is itself maintained and owned by the employer. The value of this perquisite shall be nil if the cost of such education or the value of benefit per child does not exceed ₹1,000 per month. Where free education facilities for such members of employee's household are allowed in nay other educational institution by reason of his being in employment of that employer, the cost of education in a similar institution in or near the locality is our value benefit. Next is medical facility. The expense coming under the perceived if perquisite are any medical facility provided by the employer to the employee and his family members in a hospital, dispensary or a nursing home maintained by the employer. Any medical expenses reimbursed by the employer for the treatment of his employee and his family members in an approved hospital subject to a maximum of ₹10,000 per annum to assessment year 1998-99. The limit of ₹10,000 has been raised to ₹15,000 per annum as per assessment year 1999-2000. Family for the purpose of valuation of medical facilities means the spouse and the children of the employee children may be dependent or non-dependent. Parents, brothers and sisters of the employee who are wholly or mainly dependent on such employee. Next is concessional journey, where the employer is liable to pay FPT, The benefit of such free or concessional journey is treated as fringe benefit as per section 115 WB Part 1 Part B, where the employer is not liable to pay FBT under Chapter 12 H Rule 3 Part 6. The value of any benefit or amenity shall be taken to be the value at which such benefit or amenity is offered by such employer to the public as reduced by the amount, if any, paid by or recovered from the employee for such benefit or amenity. However, this rule shall not apply to the employees of an airline or the railways. The last one is residual clause, that is, treatment of any other benefit, amenity, etc. provided by the employer. As per this rule, the value of any benefit or amenity, service, right or privilege provided by the employer shall be determined on the basis of the cost to the employer under an arm's length transaction as reduced by the employee's contribution, if any. However, nothing contained in this item shall apply to the expenses on telephone, including a mobile phone, actually incurred on the behalf of the employee. Now let's discuss tax-free perquisites for all employees. It includes medical facility or medical reimbursement. It includes first aid facility and medical reimbursements. Any sum paid by the employer in respect of any expenditure incurred by the employee on his medical treatment or treatment of any member of his family, subject to a maximum of Rs. 15,000 in the previous year. Food and beverages provided to employees. The free perquisite in the hand of the employees are any foods or beverage provided by the employer to his employees in the office or factory. Any foods or beverage provided by the employer to his employees through paid vouchers which are not transferable and usable only at eating joints, where the employer is not liable to pay FBT under Chapter 12H, the exemption shall be up to Rs. 50 per meal. Recreational facilities, loans to employees, perquisites provided outside India, training of employees, rent-free house or conveyance facility, residence to officials of parliament, etc., accommodation in a remote area, educational facility for children of the employer, use of health club, sports and similar facilities provided by the employer to his employee, leave travel concession. All other perquisites provided shall be tax-free perquisite as no valuation rules have been prescribed. However, in this case the employer shall have to pay fringe benefit tax on the value of such fringe benefits. However, if the employer is not liable to pay FBT, the value of such facility shall be taxable in the hand. Now, the last topic to discuss is exemptions to salary. It is not true that every income received by an employee from his employer is taxable. Any income falling within any of the following paragraphs shall not be included in computing the income from salaries. The value of any travel concession or assistance received by or due to an employee from his employer or former employer for himself and his family in connection with his proceeding. On leaving to any place in India, on retirement from service or after termination of service to any place in India is exempt under Clause 5 of Section 10, subject, however, to the condition prescribed in Rule 2B of the IT Rules 1962. Death cum retirement gratuity or any other gratuity which is exempt to the extent specified from inclusion in computing the total income. Any payment in commutation of pension received under the civil pension rules of the central government or under any similar scheme applicable to the members of the civil or defense services under the union, state, local authority or a corporation established by a central, state or provincial act. Payments in commutation of pension received under any scheme of any other employer exemption will be governed by the provisions of Section 10 10A, Part 2. Any payment received by an employee of the central or state government as cash equivalent of the leave salary in respect of the period of earned leave at his credit at the time of his retirement or superannuation or otherwise is exempt. In the case of other employees, it is subject to a maximum of 10-month leave. This exemption has an overall maximum limit of ₹2,40,000. Under Section 10, Part 10B, the retrenchment compensation received by a workman is exempt from income tax subject to certain limits. Under Section 10, Part 10C, any payment received by an employee of the notified bodies at the time of his voluntary retirement or termination of his service in accordance with any scheme or schemes of voluntary retirement or in the case of public sector company, a scheme of voluntary separation is exempted to the extent that such amount does not exceed 5 lakh rupees. Any sum received under a life insurance policy, including the sum allotted by the way of bonus on such policy, other than any sum received under subsection 3 of section 80 DDA. Any payment from a provident fund to which the Provident Funds Act 19 of 1925 applies. Under section 10, 13AJ of the Income Tax Act 1961, any special allowance specifically granted to an assessee by his employer to meet expenditure incurred on payment of rent in respect of residential accommodation occupied by the assessee is exempt from income tax to the extent as may be prescribed. Under Section 1014, exemption of notified allowances is provided. The CBDT has prescribed guidelines for the purpose of Clauses 1 and 2 of Section 10, Part 14, Wide Notification Number SO617E, dated 7th July 1995, F Number 142/9/95 TPL, which has been amended, Wide Notification SO Number 403E, dated 24/4/2000, F number 142/34/99 TPL. Under Section 10, Part 15, Part 4, Part 1 of the Income Tax Act, interest payable by the government on deposits made by an employee of the central government or a state government or a public sector company from out of his retirement benefits in a notified scheme is exempt. Income by the way of pension received by an individual of family pension received by any member of the family of an individual who has been in the service of the central government or state government and has been awarded Paramvir Chakra or Mahavir Chakra or Veer Chakra or such notified gallantry award is exempt. Under Section 17 of the Act, exemption from tax will also be available under prescribed conditions in respect of any medical treatment provided to an employee or any member of his family or premium paid by the employer in respect of approved medical insurance taken for his employees or reimbursement of insurance premium to the employees for such medical insurance for the employee or his family. Now let us check if we have understood the various concepts discussed in this lesson clearly. As per income tax, salary is the remuneration received by or accruing periodically to an individual for service rendered as a result of expressed or implied contract. Right or wrong? Right. Fringe benefits are compulsory for every employee to be provided by his employer. Right or wrong? Wrong. Amount received from pension and gratuity are exempt from tax under the head salary as per income tax rules. Right or wrong? Right. Now let's revise what we have studied till now. Allowance is a sum set aside for an occurrence that may or may not come to pass. Perquisite is an incidental payment, benefit, privilege, or advantage over and above regular income, salary, or wages. Fringe benefit is an employment benefit given in addition to one's wages or salary. Perquisites taxable in the hands of specified employees, Section 17, Part 2, Part 3, a motor car facility, Rule 3, Part 2, gas, electricity or water supply provided, Rule 3, Part 4, domestic servant, sweeper, gardener, watchman or personal attendant, cook, etc. Rule 3, Part 3, education facility, medical facilities provided, proviso to Section 17, Part 2. Free or concessional journey given to the transport employees and their family members, residual clause, treatment of any other benefit, amenity, etc. provided by the employer. Tax-free perquisites for all employees are medical facility or medical reimbursement, food and beverages provided to employees, recreational facilities, loans to employees, perquisites provided outside India, training of employees, rent-free house or conveyance facility, residence to officials of parliament, etc., accommodation in a remote area, etc. Heads exempt from tax under salary head are value of any travel concession, death cum retirement gratuity, pension, leave salary, retrenchment compensation, life insurance policy, provident fund, special allowance, and medical treatment.